Good morning, friends. Again, I am Professor Shivaji Patil here. I am a retired professor from Engineering College. Now, I am a trainer and coach. Today, with this small video, I am coming up with something about success. So, we all want success. So, there are two things which are very important for our life. We can call them as the life goals, or what we want in life. One is happiness, another is success. See, happiness is an internal state of mind. So you can choose it actually, happiness. You can choose to be happy in any situation, whatever may be the positive or negative situation, you can choose to be happy. We'll discuss it in later videos, how to be happy always, how to remain happy always, something like that. But today, I am going to discuss about the success. A lot of people talk about success. We have seen successful people and all. So, how success can be achieved? But before that, how success can be achieved? Let us see the definition of the success. Success is a progressive realization of a worthy goal. Progressive realization of the worthy goal. So, here, you need to have a goal. And that goal should be worthy. What do you mean by worthy? That goal should be useful for you and should make you happy, useful for your family and make them happy, useful for the society and make them happy. So your goal should be aligned with higher meaning which is useful for the entire community, then only it can be called as a goal. Otherwise, success in anything which makes you unhappy, which makes you uncomfortable, which makes your family unhappy, which makes society unhappy. So it doesn't have any meaning. You cannot call it as success. However wealth you may amass, however name and fame you may amass, but the kind of success you achieve, if it doesn't help you to grow as a person, if it doesn't make your family happy, if it doesn't make the society in which you are living happy, then it has no meaning. Therefore, success is progressive realization because, see, success cannot happen overnight. It is a journey, actually. Success is a journey. The success is a goal and moving towards success is a journey. And most important thing is we have to enjoy the journey also. It is not like we have to struggle very hard. That means even struggling hard also, of course, it is required, but it should not be stressful. We should not be stressful. So how to complete this journey of success without being stressed? Without being stressed, the only way is to develop passion towards your goal. Develop passion. Develop is the main driving force which will give you the strength and energy, enthusiasm to move fast towards your goal. So here you can see the picture. What a success involves. See, there is a picture of a glacier is there. So this what you can call it as an iceberg. It is not a glacier. You can call it as an iceberg. So this upper portion can be called tip of the iceberg, while the lower portion, the largest portion is there. See, we see only the success. That is the top portion only, which is above the water. Above the water. See, this water level indicates our conscious mind or our conscious mind, you can say. So we see only the external thing, what you call it as the success, but the internal thing, how the success has been achieved, how the journey has been taken place, what are the things that are required to attain that success, that has been listed here. There will be a lot of hard work is involved, a lot of persistence is involved. There is a late night. So normally it is applicable to the students. So you should burn your late night lamps then only success is possible. That tremendous amount of success is possible. So your dreams of making big in life is only possible if you burn your lamps at night. So that is called late nights. Then there will be rejections also. Life, in life, you have to face a lot of rejections. Even after completion of the degree, you may face rejections by few companies. So persistence and rejections are complementary to each other. Even if you are rejected, you must try again. Persistence means trying again and again. That is, even if you fall also, just you can recover and you can go on the journey, something like that. So persistence is very, very important. There will be sacrifices. So in student life, a lot of people say student life is golden life. So their perception is student life is to enjoy. What all you can enjoy? You can enjoy good food. You can enjoy movies. You can enjoy, nowadays, okay, it is there is a pub, there is a bar, there is a discotheque. So there are a number of things to enjoy. But few of them at least, you need to sacrifice. Like, okay, you can enjoy at the weekends, no problem at all. If you study hard during the weaker days, you can enjoy whatever you want in at the weekend days. Like Sunday, you can keep it totally off from the academics and you can enjoy whether you want to go to movie or anywhere you want to go to, you can enjoy. But at least for the 6 days, you need to sacrifice all these things. You need to totally focus on your studies, to your academic career, your short-term goals, your long-term goals. So long-term goal is nothing but your final goal, where you want to reach, which company you wanted to get appointed. So that is the final goal. Short-term goals means how you are going to go step by step. What are the steps you need to cover? What are the hurdles you need to face? How you are going to overcome? So those are the short-term goals, your internal examinations, your semester examinations, your final examinations, your practical examinations. These are the things they will test your ability to pursue your journey towards the success. So you have to clear all those, we cannot call those obstacles or hurdles. But you can call them as a stepping stones. You have to step on them. You have to use them as the stepping stones and reach your final destination. This is the success. Therefore, sacrifices is very, very important during. Because if you sacrifice something just for 4 years to 6 years, your degree and PG, then you can, once you attain that goal, your entire life is there to enjoy. Entire life is there to enjoy. Just 4 years of hard work, just 4 to 5 years of hard work, 50 years of enjoyment. You can imagine the kind of things. So, my dear friends, so a lot of students doesn't realize this. They want to enjoy that particular moment, that particular day, So it is an impulsive behavior. So they want to enjoy that particular moment. So all these drug addictions, smoking, drinking, just for fun of that particular minute or particular second, particular hour. So they just, they wanted to have enjoyment on the day-to-day basis. So they fall prey to all kind of bad habits. So of course, it is your money. You can do it, but you can do it when you start earning. So I don't say that everything is bad. You should be live like a sadhu. You should be live like a saint. Nothing like that. You can enjoy anything, but you can, most of the things you can enjoy after your graduation, after you get your success, your goal of attaining a good corporate job. You can very well, entire life you left to enjoy the life. Therefore, these are all very temporary enjoyments. So whatever I have said, these are all the temporary enjoyments. Permanent enjoyment is nothing but you will get when you have a family, when you have a respect in the society, when you have good relationship with everyone around your society, when you are contributing to the society, when you are looking after your family very well. So you are when you are helping some other. So these are the some of the joy you cannot measure it. You cannot. They are invaluable happy moments. So real happiness you get from all these things, contributing to society, contributing to family. So looking your family very well to everybody's satisfaction, maintaining very good relationship. So relationship is the main stress factor for an employee. So if he fails to maintain relationship in his family, then that will be projected in the office also, in office environment also, and his productivity will be drastically reduced. So therefore, my dear friends, respect, then this, what you call it as a relationship. So then contributing to the society, contributing to the entire community or entire nature, whatever you say. So that gives you tremendous happiness, and that is the real success. To achieve that kind of success, you need to be first achieve the smaller success, comparatively smaller success, which is a good job, which is a good job. So you can give only if you have money only, you can help others. At least for the sake of that purpose, to help money, so to help the people, you need to have money. If you want to have money, you need to have a good job. If you want to have a good job, then you need to have that journey of success, complete successfully with all those stepping stones, using all those stepping stones. Then focus. Focus, I've already discussed, my dear friends. Focus is avoiding 99 things which are not helping you to grow. Whereas concentrating only on one thing, choosing only on one thing which will help you to grow, which will help you to attain that success. That is called as the focus. Unbridled focus, we call it as. So that is the one of the very important stepping stone of the success. Then there should be discipline. Discipline is nothing but the way you are going to organize everything in your mind also, in your physicality also, your punctuality, your organization capability, then your, what you call it as, there is a book called as Make Your Bed. What he advises is, every morning, your discipline should start with making your bed every morning and every night. By morning, when you woke up, you have to make your bed, make it very neat. So that should be the starting point of your day. So that is the that indicates that you are a disciplined person, and you are going to use that discipline entire day. So it is the beginning of the discipline. And night also, you should make your bed. That means you have to take out the bed sheet and clean it, and then lay it on the bed. So that is called as making a bed. So making a bed, that book is there. So that is main emphasis on that book is discipline. So disciplined life, to giving respect to time, giving respect to your own health, giving respect to energy. So organizing everything so that the work may not become successful. So prioritizing the things. If you are disciplined, you prioritize the things correctly so that you can complete it within the target time and you will be less stressful or stress-free. So discipline is very, very important. Then next point is criticism. Criticism you need to take. So there is no way you can avoid criticism. Everybody will criticize, because we are expert in jumping to conclusion, and we are expert in giving advice, and we are expert in criticize. We are expert in criticize. So the entire community, entire society, including your family, are expert in jumping to conclusions, forming opinion about you. If you make a small mistake, they will form a negative opinion about you and they will criticize you. That is unavoidable. If you want to avoid it, then you have to become a sannyasi and go there to some remote places or Himalayas or something like that. So criticism, you have to face. You have to face, but we should know what we are doing, whether it is right or wrong. If we know, we will be unaffected by the criticism. we can take it as a constructive. Okay, some people of course use constructive criticism. There is something called constructive criticism. We can take it as a feedback and we can improve upon ourselves. That is a very good criticism. But some people, it is not, the criticism is not constructive, just out of jealousy or just out of intention to hurt you, they will criticize you. So you can't avoid such people. There may be such people in your family also, in the society also. So don't worry about such things. So the your friends may criticize you. In pop hall or hatti, in dot shana hatti no, dot dilu hatti no, collector hatti no. So like this, they will start criticizing you because you are avoiding their company. You want to focus on your studies. So you are burning your night lamps. So up to 12, 1 or 2 o'clock night. So naturally, your friends who want to take you out, who want to wander with you, will criticize. You have to take criticism. Then doubts. You have definitely doubts about yourself and everybody will express doubt about you. So that doubts, I already explained, self-doubt should not be there. You should banish that self-doubt. You need to be confident. God has created you as a spectacular creature. So God has made any partiality in his own creation of billions of people. So you are as good as intelligent, have same memory as the billions of people exist in this planet. Therefore, remove that doubt. I am not capable. No, I am capable. I can do. These are the things you need to put in your head with the help of the self-talk. So that is your doubts. Doubts are called as sabotaging doubts. They will sabotage your life. They will sabotage your career. They can sabotage your success. So completely remove your doubts. Then failures. Failures will be there. Despite your big efforts, your sincere efforts, your enormous hard work, what you have gone through, you may face failures. But take failures as either challenges or feedback. Why you have failed? You might have done some mistake. You might have done some last minute mistake. Or you might have not measured up to something. So the benchmark is set by some others. You might not have measured, like Olympics. Why our athletes, even though coming close to the winning medals, some of them failed? Because they failed to reach that benchmark set by other countries' sportsmen. Therefore, they failed. But that failure is not the utter failure. So they are successful in their own way. They have, even some of the athletes have improved their own records. So, my dear friends, failure is imminent in life, not only in academic career or in any sports arena, even in family area also. You may face failures. You take it as a setback. So you take it as setbacks, you take it as a feedback, learn from it, and then you can grow it. So failure, that is called as a failure. Then the risks, my dear friends, risk will always be there. You have to risk it. Suppose you want to go for IAS, IPS exam, then okay, people may discourage you. You have to take that calculated risk. You can go to a coaching center. You can go study if you have confidence. You can study on your own. You have to spend some amount. But that risk you have to take. If you want to become a self-entrepreneur, then that risk, that there will be risk of money, risk of time, risk of energy will be involved there. So if you are afraid to take risk, then you cannot reach anywhere. So risk will be there in every step in life. You have to take calculated risk. You have to weigh between the pros and cons of what you are doing. That's why you have to take conscious decisions. I have already explained what is conscious decision. The decision you take, you should know the consequences and you should be ready to face the consequences. If you want to do anything, you need to know the consequences and you have to be ready to face that consequences. So that kind of risk you need to take. So hard work, persistence, late nights, rejections, focus, sacrifices, discipline, criticism, doubts, failures, and risk. These are the things which are involved behind the screen of a successful person. For example, you have seen Neeraj Chopra, who has brought a gold medal. So you might have seen his workout video. They are simply insane. Insane how a man can train his body like that. Insane workout he has done. That's why. Why he has done so much of workout? Because to build the strength, to build the arm strength, to build the back strength, to build the leg strength. Because when in a javelin throw, you need to strengthen your arms also, strengthen your back also, because you have to bend it like this, bend back, then bend forward, you have to bend your legs. So your entire body should be strong. Then only you can throw the kind of throw he achieved. So he is the best example. He has set an example for how you can be can work out on your body. So they are actually, when I saw that video, I feel it insane, and he will give you inferiority complex. He will give you inferiority complex, how we use our body and how the sports people use their body. Okay, not only Neeraj Chopra, the PV Sindhu, the Mary Combs, the Mirabai Chanu, the Deepak Punia. So all those things, how they have been trained, how they have been worked out for their bodies based on their sport, kinds of sports, they have put immense effect. We should respect them for that. So that's why they were able to achieve that kind of fitness. So today, fitness is very, very important. A balanced diet and a fitness is very, very important. So my dear friends, the total gist of this video, why I wanted to make this video, is first thing is I want you to realize your potential. I want to you to realize your true potential. Then you have to work hard, burn your night lamps. You too should be persistent, take risk, take rejections in a positive way, then do some sacrifices. Live a disciplined life. Disciplined life means maintaining timing is also one. Time management is also comes under discipline. Then take criticism in a positive way. Self-doubt, avoid self-doubts. Take failures as the stepping stones. Take failure as the feedback. Then learn to take risk also. So my dear friends, success is not easy, but it is very, very rewarding. It is very, very rewarding. See, if you work hard for next 4 to 5 years or 6 years, so depending upon whether you pursue degree or PG or something like that, or PhD, so it may take around 6 to 8 years also, even if you go for PhD. But the life after that will be very, very rewarding, my dear friends. So I am making this video on the behalf of, you can see, Global College of PU, BCom, BBA, BCA, BMcom, Hubli. It is situated in Shatter layout. It is also called as Akshay Colony. It is on the Chetana College Road, which goes to directly to Vidyanagar. So a very well maintained, and hall have all the latest facilities. Burning blending learning will be there. Quality faculty will be there. So visionary management is there. So everything you need to have a successful journey, because success, your degree is not just a small thing. It is a journey itself. So if you want a smooth journey, then you can join us, and we'll definitely handhold you, and we can even train you to become a most demanding candidate in job market. Most demanding candidate in job market. So this is what I wanted to convey to you. So my dear friends, thanks for listening. If you like this video, subscribe this my channel. Subscribe my channel so that you can get notification. I will be giving releasing a lot of motivational videos, even for Global College also, even for myself also. I am an NLP trainer and coach. So for that also, I am releasing. So you can get notifications. And I hope you join Global College, and I wish you all the best, all the success in your future life. Thank you for active listening this particular video. Thank you very much.